Hey, welcome to school. It is Friday, fabulous Friday, fun Friday, fauna Friday, whatever you want to call it. It is the end of the week and you've made it. Today's lesson will not be nearly as long as the others. We're just going to have fun and review and see how much you learn this week. All right. So if you want to make this video bigger, click down there on that YouTube button. So, cat out of the bag, okay? First things first. Yes, my wife is a genius. All right. I got messages all day yesterday about how Mrs. Ritenour is smarter than Mr. Ritenour because she knew how to solve that hexagon problem. And yes, my wife is smarter and better than me in every single way. All right. And I hope that she's listening right now. All right. So, if you're wondering why I'm wearing this hat, it's because my hair is out of control and I can't get it cut because all the barber shops and salons are closed right now. So, I'm contemplating possibly having Kaylee cut it for me. But yeah, that could be really bad. So, she claims if she watches some YouTube videos, she'll be able to do it, but if you have a way of getting haircut and you know like something on the down low, something secret, have your parents message me because this is getting crazy. So anyway, I'll be wearing a hat today for that reason. All right, so let's jump in here with some common sense. Today's words of wisdom. If someone drops something, bend over and pick it up for them. All right? You are more than capable of doing that at your age. Helping others pick up things is one of the nicest, most polite things that you can do. All right? So, men, all the boys in the room, all right? If you're ever on a date, I know, like 20 years down the road, if your date drops something, you better pick it up for her because that's what being a gentleman is all about. And ladies, my girls, if you do drop something and your date doesn't pick it up for you, psht, get out of there because he is not a gentleman. All right, and you deserve better. Okay, that is my common sense lesson for today. Let's move on to something that we haven't done yet this week. That we're probably only going to do once a week on Fridays, and that is spelling. I know you're all like celebrating. Woohoo! Yeah, spelling! I love spelling. Well, guess what? It's your lucky day. Here's what we're going to do, all right? Pause the video and go get a notebook because that's what you're going to need for today. You don't need your Go Math book, you don't need simple solutions. All you need is a notebook to write some stuff down, all right? So go get that right now and then come back. All right. Today we are going to do spelling and it's going to be really simple, all right? This is not a test. I'll repeat, this is not a test. This is just a quick practice of our words. All right. So I'm going to say the word and then I'm going to like count to 10 in my head and give you like 10 seconds to write it. And then I'm going to write the correct version of the word and you can match it up and see if it's correct. And if you get it wrong, no big deal. Just cross it out and write it correctly next to it, okay? All right. So number your paper right now, 1 to 15. Remember, it's a review week. We only have 15 words. All right, so I've got my cell phone with the words on it. Number one. Number one is choose. Choose. Okay. Choose is spelled C. H O S. E. Right, choose. It sounds like it has a Z, but it's not. It's an S. All right, give yourself a star or an X. Remember, no one can see but you, so just be honest with yourself. All right, word number two. Booth. Booth. Okay. Booth is spelled B O O T H. Booth. Okay, I'm already getting bored of this, so I'm gonna try to make it more fun. Number three, I'm not gonna tell you the word. I want you to figure out what it is. Number three, it's the thing that's at the bottom of your leg, all right, that you'd use to kick a soccer ball. What's that called? It's got toes on it. It's called a foot, right foot. Okay, F. O-O-T, foot. Number four. This is what happens if you get hit with something, like maybe get punched or you fall. You might get one of these. They're black and blue. Nice. A bruise. Bruise. Okay, it's B R U I. That's the U S E. Bruise. All right, number five. The past tense of throw. I throw the ball today. Yesterday, I the ball. Nice, it's through. Good job. Okay, let's do it. T H th r r u e w. Through. Not to be confused with the homophone through, like I went through the tunnel. That would be T H R O U G H, right? Okay, coming at you. Number six. The antonym. Have to know what that word means. The antonym of hard. Soft. Antonym means opposite. So the opposite of hard is soft. S O F T. Once again, give yourself a star or an X. All right, number seven. Let's see. This is a reading word. It comes before effect. It's like blank and effect. Cause. Cause and effect. Okay, cause. See. A U S E cause. Now, some might have wrote this cause I said so, but that's not right. That's just slang. It's C A U S E. All right, folks, number eight. This is what you need to do with meat in your freezer. So that you can cook it. If it's all frozen, you need it to blank out. Thaw. Thaw. All right, thaw is T H A W. Thaw. Number nine. The opposite of true is false. False. Okay, false. F A L S E. False. Good work. Number 10, número 10, estudiantes. This is a place where kids go before kindergarten to learn. Preschool. Preschool. Okay. Preschool starts with the prefix pre, meaning before. And then school. School is always a tricky word for students because it's actually SCH, like the Greek. The CH makes a k sound. Preschool. Kind of like in Percy Jackson, whenever we're reading, I always say Chiron. That's because the CH at the beginning is actually a k sound. So preschool is CH. Numero 11, that means 11. Okay, if you spelled a word wrong, you blank the word. Sorry, this one's tricky. The answer is misspell. Misspell. There are two S's in that, by the way. Hint. Okay. Start with miss, which means the opposite. Spell. Spell. So misspell. Hopefully you don't misspell misspell, right? That'd be ironic. Number 12, the opposite of outdoors. Indoors. Okay, indoors starts with in, which is a prefix that literally means in. Doors, DOORS. Inside the door would be indoors, right? Outdoors would be the opposite, outside the doors. Okay, number 13. If you break something up, you tear it apart. Apart. A P A R T, apart. Number 14. Let's see. This is a preposition that means if you want to walk to the other side of something, you would walk blank the street. Or maybe you're on a bridge and you wanted to get to the other side, you'd have to walk blank the bridge. Across, across. Okay, so across is A, and then cross, C R O double S, across. Last one, number 15. How we doing? How we doing? All right. Hopefully you're all like, good. I love spelling, Mr. R. This is so awesome. I'm so glad that you did that today. I know that's what you're not thinking. Last word. Around. Sorry, I just told it to you. Around. Around. So A, round, ROUND, around. Yay! Good job. You did it. All 15 words. This was a review week, so you've already learned these words in class before the shutdown. Hopefully you did well. Let's see, if you missed one, you got an A. If you missed two or three, you got a B. Four or five, you got a C. And then you can do the math from there, all right? So hopefully everyone got at least a 10 out of 15. If not better, please. These are words that we should already know. Okay, moving on. Next, actually, before we move on, I'm going to give you a chance to take a little break. While you're taking your break, come back whenever you're ready with a blank piece of paper because we are going to do a math review. Okay, let's do it. Time for math. Okay. So today's math lesson is, I think, 22 questions, and each question is from something that we've learned this week, whether it was from 12.1, 12.2, or 12.3. All these questions are like me figuring out how well you understood these distance lessons. And I hope that with this review game, one, you'll be more confident. Two, if you're a little fuzzy on some of this stuff, hopefully by going through these problems, this extra practice right now, it'll help clarify some things for you. That way, moving forward next week, you've got a firm grasp because all this stuff that we're talking about is the foundation of geometry. All right, so think about building a house, okay? Would you build a house on a swamp? No, right? Because it would sink. You want to build a house on something sturdy like concrete or rock, and that's what we're doing right now. We're building that foundation, all right? We don't want something that's swampy. We want something that's strong and tough. All right? Tough, just like you, Michael Knopp. All right, so let's start with question number one. Okay, that is not a pimple. What do we call that in geometry? And don't write dot. So write that answer down on your paper. Number one is A. Let's see, Jasper, you're up first. Good work. Number one, the answer is point. Nice. It's a point. Number two. Evan, you're up. You've got arrows on both sides. It goes on forever. What do we call that, Evan? Everyone write it down. Remember, if you get it wrong, no big deal. Just make sure you learn from it. What do I always say, boys and girls? Mistakes only happen when we don't learn from them. Good job. So, Evan, did you get a line? If you did, yahoo! You're absolutely right. That's called a line. All right, what if we take out the arrows and we add endpoints? So we've got a start, sorry, start and a finish. What do we call that, London? Did you get a line? Good work, kid. A segment. Line, segment. Okay, number four. So we combine a line and a segment. We've got endpoint right here, point, and then we've got the arrow on this side. Let's see, who's up? Sophie, what do we call that? Think about the sun, okay? That is called. Nice work, Sophie. Array. Moving on, number five. Open or closed? That's a circle, folks. Bobby, open or closed? That one is closed, Roberto. I can't get into it anywhere, right? I'm blocked. I can try, I can't. It's closed the whole way around. Moving on. Number six. Open or closed? Lucas. Good work, Sergeant Settle. That one is definitely open. You can see right here, you can get inside that shape. It's not connected on all the sides. Right, number seven. So the first six questions were from 12.1. That would be Monday. All right. The next few questions are from Wednesday's lesson. Because remember, Tuesday we didn't do math, we did number facts. So number seven, how many line segments? Patina, count those sides up. How many did you get? I hope you got Ocho, the eight. So bonus question, Bettina, what do you call that shape? It might be later in the quiz, so pay attention, everyone. What was that, Peyton? Octagon? Genius. It is. Always think about eight. What animal that lives in the ocean has eight legs? An octopus, right? So an octagon is an eight-sided shape. Nice work, Cogswell. Okay. Number eight. I gave a hint for this one. This is the hardest, I think, question on this review quiz because we didn't talk about it very much, but we did mention it. So let's see. Who am I on? I'm on Cody. Are you up for this challenge? Number eight. What are corners called? So the corners of the shapes. I gave you a hint. It starts with a V and it ends with an X. Did you get it, Cody? It's called a vertex. A vertex. That was a tough one. The corners of all shapes are called a vertex. Now, if you have more than one, it changes names. Okay? We talked about it briefly. They're called vertices. That means like if you had like five corners, you'd have five vertices, okay? But each one individually is called a vertex. All right, good job. Number nine. This one's also pretty tricky, so I gave a little hint here. We're on Peyton Fisher. Every vertex, so every corner, has a measurement in degrees called an. Good work, fish. It's called an angle, right? And you know that because you've already passed that in number facts. On the number fact elevator, the elevator is closed with the coronavirus. Oh my gosh, that just made me think of all of our plants. I don't know why, probably because the number fact elevator is right next to on the back counter, right next to our plants. But all of our green beans that we planted, I don't know it. They probably are all dead by now. Oh, I'm so sad. It's okay. If we do get school back before the end of the year, we can always plant something else. So sad. All right, number 10. So we said every corner or vertex has an angle, right? Measured in degrees. Well, a 90-degree angle, which is like a perfect corner, is called a what? Jacob Dubiel. Yep, it's just right. It's a right angle. Right, because it's perfect. Now, most of the time, you're gonna see a box, like that little blue box. That tells the person that's looking at the shape that that's a right angle. There might be times though where they don't have the box, but it'll be like a perfect corner like that, and then you can just assume that that's a right angle, okay? So most of the time they're gonna give you this little box here to show you that it's a right angle, but they might not always. Just a heads up. All right, Popovich, you're up next. And I don't want you to tell me less than or greater than a right angle. I want you to actually tell me what kind of angle it is. I know you can do it, Emily. What kind of angle is that? Think it's little. Little things are usually very acute. Nice, good job. That's an acute angle. Which brings us to the opposite. The opposite of an acute angle, a big fat angle, is called what, Willow? Hint, obtuse. Good work, Parker. That is an obtuse angle. Okay, we're more than halfway there, folks. Keep up the good work. Ooh, this is a great question. All right, it's a three-part question, so I'm going to call on three students. All right, Michael, you get the first one. Look at the yellow arrow, Michael, over on the right side of your screen. What two angles are those? They're both perfect corners. Hope you got that, Mikey. They're both right angles. All right, Carson. Look at the green angle. All right. This green angle is bigger than a right angle, which means it is obtuse. All right, Smalley, good work. And Mr. Shep, purple, my favorite color. That one looks to be smaller, which means it is acute. Good job, Wiley. So we're moving on. Number 14, we're back up to you, Jasper. Which shape does not have a right angle? I'll give you a second to look at them. All right, Jasper, what'd you get? T, you are absolutely correct. Let's go look quickly at the other ones. You see, we've got a right angle right there and right there. So that one definitely does have a right angle. Shape R has a right angle on all four corners, right? That's a rectangle. And shape S is actually just a square that's been turned. It has four right angles as well. But T, look at T. It's got these corners are acute, they're smaller. And then you got big, fat, obtuse corners. There are no right angles, which means this one is our answer. Good work, Jasper. Jasper, I love that yesterday. You sent me that video of you answering the question while you're watching the lesson. So I hope that you just did that right now. That was a great moment in my day yesterday. All right, number 15. All right, Evan, you're up. 2D shapes, so two-dimensional shapes, flat, that are closed and only have straight sides. All right, line segments are called what? This one's tough, Evan. What if I give you the first part of the word? Poly. Good. Polygons. Polygons are 2D shapes that are flat and have straight sides. So if I were to erase number 14 real quick. If you look at each of these shapes, they're all closed, right? And they all have straight sides. So every single shape in question 14, these are all polygons. What if I threw in one of these? What if I threw in like an oval? That'd be wrong. An oval is not a polygon because it does not have straight sides. Okay, good work, Evan. We're moving on here. Number. Please work. There we go. Number 16. Which shape is the polygon? So, four options. Three of them are not. I'll give you a chance to look at it. Should be familiar because it came straight from yesterday's quiz. All right, Lulu, what'd you get? C is correct. So, London, why isn't A a polygon? Yeah, it doesn't have straight sides. It's round. It has curved sides. All right, so this one is no good. How about B, London? Why is that not? Yeah, it's got curved sides and it's not closed. This one's a big no-no. All right, C we said was right because it has all straight sides and it's closed. You can't get inside that shape. But D has two straight sides. I think I asked Jasper this question yesterday. But it also has that round part, that curved edge. So D would not be correct either because of that reason. All right, good work, Lulu. Number 17. We are on Soph. Name that polygon. So don't tell me rectangle for this one, okay? Because I know that you know that, Sophie. I want you to tell me the general name for all four-sided shapes. If it has four sides and it's a polygon, it is a. Good. A quad quadrilateral. So lateral means side. Straight side, straight line up to the side, and quad means four. So four straight sides. All right, good job, Sophie. Name that polygon, Bobby. Well, the only way to find out is to count the sides. Uno, dos, tres, which means that is a tri, means three, angle. No, triangle. Good work, Bobby. Wait, bonus question. Because some of you I already know have done triangles in number fact elevator. This triangle has, let's see, it has one, three different sides. What do we call that? It's very fishy. Hint, hint. I'm not talking about you, Peyton. That would be a scalene triangle. If you got that, give yourself a pat on the back. I've got no money or candy to give you from afar. I'm sorry. Name that polygon, Lucas. That one has six sides, which makes it six. Has an X in it, just like hexagon. Six sides. Think about the X in hexagon. All right, we're almost there, boys and girls. You're crushing it. We're doing so great here. Number 20. Name that polygon. Patina. Oh my goodness. I think I asked you this question earlier today. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Did you remember? I hope so. What are the chances? The Lord is smiling on us today, boys and girls. That was crazy. Same question twice, Patina. Octagon. All right, 21. Name that polygon. This is the hardest polygon to remember, I think. Cody, you get two hard questions today. It either looks like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Or it might look like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. At 10 sides means it is, I think 10 years is a decade, so 10 sides is a decagon. That brings us to our last question. Number 22. Name that polygon. Sorry, I went too far. Everyone else. So Fish, Doobie, Emily, Willow, Michael, Carson, Wiley, it's your turn to answer. What kind of polygon is that? It's got one, two, three, four, five. Pentagon. That is a Pentagon. Woohoo! That's my GIF. SpongeBob. Done and done. Congratulations. Hopefully you learned a little bit, or at least if you didn't learn anything new, which you might not have because it's all review, hopefully it reinforced these important foundational skills. So we're ready to build the rest of our house on something sturdy. We are not building on a swamp. Good work, boys and girls. All right, so if you want, you can take a quick break, but you don't really need to because I'm just going to end the day here on some trivia. A couple questions to send you off on your weekend because it is Friday, folks. Look at that. That's Campbell right there. Woohoo! Trivia time! Yeah! Look at those moves. That's actually not Campbell, but I could see him doing that. Can't stop. That's hilarious. So I'll let that play in the background here while I ask you my trivia questions. All right. So first question, and I don't have any prizes for you, but do this for your own reward of just knowing. Maybe you can ask mom or dad to give you a high five if you get it right. Number one, music question. Here we go. How many notes? Sorry, I already messed up. How many whole notes are in an octave? 5 seconds. Time's up. The answer is eight. Think about it. Octave. Oct means what in geometry? Octagon, octopus. Yep, it means eight. So an octave is eight notes. Now, for those of you that haven't studied music, it's really simple to know the notes because it's just A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. The first eight letters of the alphabet are your eight whole notes. All right, so if you look at a piano, you've got eight notes, eight keys, white keys, and then it starts over. Okay, that's an octave. Number two, some vehicles like big trucks don't take gasoline. Instead, their engine needs this type of fuel. 5 seconds. Time's up. The answer was diesel. Diesel fuel. Okay, my brother-in-law has a diesel truck and it is like so loud and it shoots all this smoke. Yeah, I think it has like 400,000 miles on it. It's one of those trucks that's just gonna run until it rusts out. Next question, number three, trivia question number three. This comes from, I think, Tuesday or Wednesday, I can't remember. Which type of blood vessels look blue but are actually just dark red or purple? 5 seconds. Okay, time's up. The answer is veins. So if you look at your wrist or your arm, you can see what looks like blue lines. All right, if you remember from that video that we watched on Mystery Science, it looks blue, but it's actually not because blood doesn't change color like that drastically. It's really just a darker reddish purple. All right, because your veins are the tubes that the blood that doesn't have oxygen comes back to your heart in. Okay, your arteries are what is the oxygen-rich blood that takes it to the other parts of your body. Okay, that was a good review of some science from this week. Let's move on here. The last trivia question, and then I'm going to send you on your way for the weekend. Okay? Name that literary device. My vacuum was a black hole. So here are your choices. Here are your options for literary devices. Is it a simile, a metaphor, or personification? All right, I'll read it one more time. My vacuum was a black hole. Okay, time's up. Did you hear the word like or as? My vacuum was a black hole. No, you didn't. So right off the bat, we can eliminate simile. Simile has to be like or as. My vacuum was a black hole. Am I comparing the vacuum to something human? Something personable. No, I'm not. A black hole is not a person-like quality, which means it is not personification. That leaves one choice left. My vacuum was a black hole. Am I directly comparing a vacuum to something? Yes, I am. Cha-ching! I'm comparing it to a black hole because it just sucks everything up. It's so powerful. So that is a metaphor, my friends. Okay, well, I hope that you all had a good week of distance learning, and I hope that you enjoyed our powwow on Wednesday. I know I really did. That was probably my favorite part of the week, was seeing you guys. All right, well, I'll see you back here on Monday with a new week's lesson. Just a reminder, you don't have to do anything but the Google form, all right? You don't need to be keeping track of a weekly agenda or anything like that. I'm doing all that for you, okay? All you have to do is log in, watch this video, and then answer those questions afterward on the Google form and click submit. You do that, and you're getting credit for every single day of school. So, congratulations, you are done with week one. Have a good weekend. Mr. R is out.
Ladies and gents, this is the moment you've waited for. You've been searching in the dark, your sweat soaking through the floor. Buried in your bones, there's an ache that you can't ignore. Taking your breath, stealing your mind, and all that was real is left behind. Don't fight it, it's coming for you, running at you. It's only this moment, don't care what comes after. Your fever dream, can't you see you getting closer? To surrender, cause you feel the feeling taking over. It's fire, it's freedom, it's flooding open. It's a preacher in the pulpit and you're blind to bullshit. There's something breaking at the brick of every wall, it's holding all that you know. So tell me, do you want to go? Where it's coming?
What will you be doing?
Watching my girls grow up. The show must go on.